No, it freaked out. Oh god, this isn't going well. I thought this would be easy. Hello everybody and welcome back to Simulate Gaming and welcome back to Sandy Bay here on Farming Simulator 17. So we're slowly approaching the end, we're getting ready for our final we're planting and then we're going to be harvesting. It's going to be our final harvest and then I'll probably continue the rest either on live streams or off camera because I'm really enjoying the map playing it, but I don't think much people are enjoying watching it anymore. Let me know in the comment section if you are. But yeah, today we're doing a bit of yard work because we've got our hired worker Billy Bob out seeding some beets. There's another root crop that we're planting. But we need to, first of all, clean out these cows, because they've been a little bit neglected for a few days, but give them a good old clean out. Now let's get our, I'm not sure if I got a button mapped out for it, but we'll get our work lights on here, just so we can see what we're doing. I wish there was an interior light on this thing. Why are we not picking anything up? That's another question. So hey, welcome back, I hope you guys are well. I've been trying to push out these videos, but it's been a very busy time here in the UK, so I've been pretty much busy, but things about to get a lot worse, unfortunately, because there's a possible chance, little personal, like, little inside sight into my personal life, I may be moving to Bristol, which isn't that far away, to be fair, but, you know, still a big change. So yeah, me and my girlfriend might be moving to there, so that's always interesting, see how that goes, but it'd be a shame to say goodbye to this beautiful city. For those of you that don't know, I am from a place in the UK called Plymouth. That probably means nothing to anybody watching this, but there we go. Collect the rest of this real quick. I think that was it. There's a tiny, tiny piece here that I just saw. And I think we're done. There it is. So I'll collect this piece here as well. Like so. And what we're going to do is go back and do one last little pass just to double check to make sure we've got every single last piece. So they've actually eaten quite a lot, but the food usage has gone down quite a lot as well because it is now spring and they don't eat as much in the spring. Basically, they don't eat much. Well, they eat more in the winter. This is with seasons mod, guys. They eat more in the winter. And then spring and autumn's pretty much like the normal stuff. Winter, they hardly eat anything because they just live on the grass outside, I suppose. But let's go ahead and turn that work light off there. So yeah, we haven't got that much to do, but we are going to be giving them a good old feed today. Ugh, wrong way. I didn't realize it opened in woods. God, it's been a long time since I've been in here. There we go. Let's try that again, shall we? And we are stuck. Fantastic. Let's try again. I didn't realize the gate opened inwards. My mistake. So open that gate there. Oh, gosh. Well, things are going well today. Things are going well. As you can see, I'm recording at 6 minutes past 10 at night. So I'm a little bit tired. But I've been out all day enjoying the sunshine. Where is the food trough? Here's the food trough. Cool. So we're putting this into here. The scrap grass basically goes into here, so we'll go ahead and chuck that in. There we go. It wasn't that much, but at least the feeding area is now clean. And now we'll go and take this bucket off, and what should we do? We need a silage fork and some bales, so we might possibly need the bale fork as well, but I'm going to try something. In real life, I have seen people pick up bales with a silage fork, like they grab it, they stick into it basically. So we're going to try and see if we can use that to pick up bales. I'm not sure if farm sim physics will let us, but we'll give it a go anyway. And we have our feeder back out. We had to dust it off. It's been a while since we used it. If you haven't seen our feeder, I will show you it right now. It is the something Berg, something Berg. There it is, the blue one. Lomberg, or can't remember. We'll have a look at it in a minute properly in case you guys haven't seen it before. But yeah, we're basically just doing some yard work today. So after we feed and all the animals and stuff, we're going to be doing a little bit of maintenance on the tractors. Now, I was going to make a whole video of that, but we've already done so. I don't want to sound like I'm repeating the episodes. So we'll just put it at the end as a little bonus, basically. We need to go and, well, actually, more specifically, we need to maintain our harvester because it's been a long time since we did that, and I've got a feeling it won't even start. So we'll give that a go. All right, go, 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 go. So we'll collect up our agrum fork here, reverse that out like so. Cool. And we can go and get some silage ready. So We're using JCB power today. Why not? It's our smallest tractor, and it's got four-wheel steering, and this is articulated, of course, which is our only telehandler at the moment, at least. Make sure nothing's coming. It should be, because it's a private road, but double check. Still got a bit of snow on the ground. It does take a while to melt away, but the piles are getting smaller and smaller, so they are definitely melting away. Bales are slowly disintegrating. We need to hurry up with those bales. For those of you that don't know, Seasons Mod does disintegrate your bales over time. At the moment, there's no way to see what's left of the bale, basically, without sticking a fork into it. It would be nice one day to see it like the bale extension was on FS15, where you can just walk up to it and it comes up with a hood sort of thing. That'd be cool. But I don't know if there's any plans for that as of yet. So there's a JCB in position. Now, we're working by ourselves today because, like I said, we've got our one and only worker out seeding today, Billy Bob. So we're going to go run back and get the mixer and we'll crack on with feeding these animals. Now, I'm not actually sure how much silage we'll need. So we'll probably put two forks in and then we'll see how much hay we can get in. And then we may fill it up with straw, but I'm not sure just yet. So bear with me. Right, okay. So here we are back at the silage clamp now. Now, there's bound to be at least one person that asked about those bales there. So I'll tell you what's wrong with those bales in a minute. We'll just quickly reverse this up to here. Now, also, I did challenge is slipping. We'll have to sort that out in a minute. But a lot of people were getting annoyed at the last video because I said I'd show you what was different about this JCB because I completely forgot to show you. So I'll quickly show you now. If I press Control Y, we have four-wheel steering. Once again, not realistic. The 3000s in real life do not have that, but it's just something that we thought would be a cool addition, so we did that. We'll make a start on this. I'm just going to go ahead and turn that worker off. Right, guys, we're in the JCB. Just go ahead and get this fork lifted up here. And we need to take the sheet off this to begin with. But, these bales here, we do have some bales that we could use, but these have been bought by the local barn. We need to take them down when we get a spare 5 minutes. But for now, we will just start digging into this. This is the first time I've ever done this, which is why it's only a little bit full. But it may look like it's barely filled up, but this silage clamp has still got about 600,000. In fact, we'll be able to see how much, isn't it? 621,000 litres of silage is in here, which is a lot. That's about, we worked it out. It's about 600 bales or something. Something ridiculous like that. People in the comment section worked it out. So it's more bales than we'll ever possibly need before the next harvest. So that's why we only filled it up like that. Should be more than enough. And we'll dump out our first... Come on, JCB. There we go. And we'll dump in our first load here. Now, we should have the mixer hood on. I think I just turned it off without realising. There we go. So we turn that on. We can see exactly how full it is. Now, this mod where it shows you the mixing levels and stuff is on the mod hub. Dump that into there like that. Unfortunately, it only shows us the mix levels, not the full levels. The fill levels, that's what I meant, sorry. Okay, so at the moment it's 100% silage. So that's not really helping just yet. I was hoping it would give us the actual fill level of the thing. Never mind. So we'll get one more bucket for now at least. There we go. The cover's come off it already, which is strange. Let's get that closed down. Swing her around. And we'll get this final bucket in. Well, final for now at least. And we'll see if we can get some hay put into there, shall we? There we go. Whack that in there like that. Cool. So this is going to be the moment of truth. Can we pick up bales with this fork? Like I said, I have seen it done in real life, but whether Farm Sim will let us do it is another story. I don't think the actual fork on it actually has effect on the grip or anything, so it may not work. But we'll give it a go. We'll give it a go. If not, we'll just go get our bale fork. In fact, we got a bale fork here. It's just a little bit too big for what we want today. It's more for moving bales and selling bales. Right, so let's see if we can do this. Once again, this is only a little science experiment here. A little experiment we're doing. We'll see if we can pick it up. I'm hoping we can. Right. Close that down. Oh, we can! Fantastic. We're in the wrong gear. Go back. There we go. So we can actually grip the bales with this silage fork, which is amazing. I did not realise that. So there we go. We've done something new every day. Maybe at least one of you guys didn't know that, so now you know. That's fantastic. I love that. Absolutely love it. But now we just got to put it into the mixer wagon. It's only a little drive. It shouldn't take too long at all. And we'll see, when we print this in, we'll see what the actual field level is. So as you can see, this is a full hay bale. Not sure how it hasn't rotted away yet. Because it's been there for a good while. It's been there since summer, I think. So it's nearly a year. And it hasn't actually deteriorated, which is quite interesting. Dump that into there like that. Wow. I know it's only a small thing, but I'm blown away the fact that you can use the bales with that fork. And we are 74% full now, and judging by this, we could put some straw in, but it may ruin the ration. I think we've got a little bit. We could put more hay in. Tell you what, we'll try a straw bale. Now the reason I'm going to risk it is because the straw has been there for a long, long time. So I'm hoping that some of it's deteriorated, basically. So with the seasons mod, it's a bit like bale care, basically. You have to look after your bales, so you put them into the shed, and they last a bit longer, but it does slowly deteriorate. So if we go into this, it won't be 4,000, it'll be whatever it's in there, basically. So we'll give it a go. Unless this one has only just appeared. Maybe there was one on top of this 5 minutes ago, which means this example may be... Oh, there we go. So 2,444. Cool. Get that four-wheel drive on. No, we didn't miss that. Dang it. For some reason, you can pick up the bales of this, but it doesn't seem to like it, which is strange. So, grip that again. Drag her out so we don't take the rest of them with us. Awesome. I am really blown away by the fact that we can actually do this. This is just me experimenting. Oh, I sound like a broken record, but I am amazed. So we'll get this hay in. Like I said, the good example of that is this one here. So now it was a full bale, but because it's been sat there for a while, it is now only 2,444. Oh, I did not mean to do that. Did not mean to do that. There we go. I was meant to lift it up, but I accidentally opened it. God, this joystick's confusing sometimes. Right, we'll get that put into here like so. Please don't mess up the ration. Let's just move this camera around so we can see a bit better. Okay, we'll drop her in like so. And that looks pretty much done to me. We haven't messed up the ration, so only 21% of straw. And it's 95%, so we're not going to get much more in that. In fact, it'd be a waste if we put more in there. So what we're going to do is start up the fast track, and we'll go unload our first load. Now, I just thought we could have actually put some silage in, but it's not really worth it for whatever it is, 5%. But before we get over there, let's just make sure we're loading onto the correct side, which is tip side left. Cool. Yeah, we're doing that. So whilst we head over, we'll get it turned on, if it will let me. Doesn't work with this side panel for some reason. There we go. So the mixer wagon is now on, so it'll be mixing away all the goodness back there. And it is total mixed ration as well, so hopefully it actually registers as power food, because last time it didn't. I think there was something wrong with our measurements or something, but hopefully it will actually register this time. We do also need to blow some straw as well, actually, I just realised. So that's something else we need to do in a minute. Right. Here we go. What I like doing is putting the cruise control onto 1 mile an hour here. And we'll give this a go. Now, how do I actually use this thing? I, wasn't it? Which means it'll be this button here on the side panel. Yep, there we go. So we're slowly unloading here now at 1 mile an hour. And the cow should start running towards it. There's one there already. That one's, that one's Sherry, that one. That's what we call her. Sherry! And there is our first load done. So let's quickly see how that's actually affected the cows. I got a feeling it's going to be hardly anything. Actually, no, it's done quite a lot. Like I said, that would have only done about a quarter in the winter, but because it's spring, it's done quite a lot of it, so that's really handy. You do need to give them some straw, and they also need some water. Apparently, they're only 61% clean, which doesn't make sense, because we've literally just cleaned them out. Maybe there's some under the ground sinks, so we might get the tyre to fix that. Maybe the tyre will fix it. So now we just need... We've got no grass to give them, unfortunately. We need some straw and some water. All this talk about water is making me feel very thirsty. So reverse that here. There's no need to go turn around. There we go. Let's go ahead. Reverse that here. That was quite smooth. Well done, Sir Billy. Well done, sir. Right, we'll leave this here temporarily because I do want to rearrange the yard off camera. So for now, what we're going to do is jump out, disconnect this, disconnect that, Double check to make sure it's empty. Yep, cool, completely empty. So we'll jump back in to the JCB and we'll go and collect our blower now. Let's turn that off. I want that turned off as well, actually. There we go. I'm getting bad FPS again for some reason. We're stuck on something. I think it was a snow pile then. Ooh. Right, so what way is our blower facing? The water and the blower is right next to each other, so it doesn't really matter which order we do it in, but we are going to start with the blower so we can get the front load of stuff out the way. Well, telehand the stuff out the way, at least. Okay. Traverse up to here. Right, let's get that back into forward here. We'll jump out, hook this all up. If it will let... Oh, it's a bit close to comfort there, to the water bowser. Hook that up. That's not what I wanted. That's the wrong thing. X. There we go. Oh, what the heck? That's... I found a bug. I found a bug. Oh my gosh, I think we've actually got the bowser and the blower on there. Can we pull this away? Ooh, that was close. That was a bit unrealistic. Well, not really. Suppose you could put two on if you wanted. Let's close that door real quick. That's the first time we've ever done that. We managed to somehow connect the bowser and the blower to the same thing. Interesting. Let's go ahead and get ourselves some straw here. So we'll stop about here. Get it turned off. Close her up. And yeah, we'll go get... How many straw bales do you reckon we can get into here? About two? In fact, I forgot to do something. Let's just quickly jump into here. Get the back unfolded. Because we're using square bales. Get that closed just in case a thief comes. Cool, and we'll go collect the telehandler. Right, so there's the harvesters. These are what we're going to be working on today because we're going to need them very soon. We just reviewed the trucks as well whilst we're here. We need to do everything at some point, but we don't have time to do all of it today. So let's drive into here. We'll pick ourselves up another straw bale. Let's rotate the camera. That's what we're talking about, the camera around here. And we will lift that up. Close that down. There we go. There's one. Drive that forward. Now, hopefully we can drop this in first time. Sometimes it gets a bit skew-whiff and then we can only end up getting one in, but we're going to do our best today to get all of them in. Right, there we go. There's our first one lined up at least. Right, lift that up. Use the sides to drag it out. Awesome. In fact, we may only be able to get one in there. We'll try another one. If it don't go in, it don't go in. But the first one's in at least. Let's get one more here. We want to get it from the top if we can, but I don't think we're going to be able to reach because the top ones deteriorate first. There we go. Let's collect that one. I haven't got much of a grip on this one, so hopefully it doesn't fall off. Right. Oh, no, we dropped it. Dang it. Get that lifted up. Push her away. No, that should do. Get her lifted up. This is what I do like about the articulated telehandler. So even though it's on a bit skew-whiff, we should be able to line her up using the articulation. Maybe, possibly. Just a little bit of adjusting. Go back. There we go. Stop. There we go. Right. Reverse out. Awesome. We managed to do that. I don't know how, because I usually fail at stuff like this, but we managed to do it. And we don't want to park in there because that's where our water is. So for now, we'll just temporarily leave it here. There we go. Get it turned off. And we'll go give these cows some straw, shall we? So I think we can actually, if this is the one I'm thinking of, it might be just the McHale. But we might be able to strap these in. Actually, it doesn't look like we can. We'll just have to drive safe, I reckon. Never mind. So we'll jump in to the JCB once again. Get her booted up. That's a wrong gear simulate. Well done, sir. Right, let's see if we can reverse onto the main road here without messing things up. Oh gosh, I'm a bit worried about this. I'm not convinced that top bale's actually registered as being in the mixer. The blower, sorry, so it's gonna be interesting. Come on. Are you going to stay in? No, I'm not convinced. Not convinced at all. Steady. In fact, are we dragging the bottom? Nothing I can do about that. We're just going to be making sparks on the bottom, unfortunately. Alright, there we go. Actually, what side's the blower on? And we're facing the wrong way. Fantastic. So we have to go and turn around, I reckon. Because the blower is facing the opposite direction to what we want. So, we'll open the gate. Hopefully Sandra will move out of the way. Boop. There we go. Let's get that open. That. Sandra, where'd you go? Good. Right, make sure we don't hit Boris as well. Oh, there's Sandra coming back. Say there, you. Right, concentration face is on now. There we go. And we'll stop blowing this. So I think we can actually control. Oh, wow. So it only takes one bale. That's a shame, but we're still registered as two, which is a bit annoying. Let's go ahead and close that up. What I'm going to do is do something that's probably a no-no, but I'll do it anyway. I'm going to reverse this and leave it in here, though it won't let me reverse for some reason. I think the little hatch that we're dragging backwards is getting in the way, I think. Let's try this a minute. Maybe I'll have better look. Oh gosh, something terribly bad has happened. What is going on? Nope, that's glitched out. What is happening to this? Okay then. If any of you guys know what's going on, please let me know. Maybe it is the back. It was. Okay. Right, that was completely my fault, that was. The hatch was just dragging along the floor so much that it decided to freak out the back wheels. But we fixed it. We got it off. Realism, yo. And now, like I said, we just need, finally, the water bowser. Are we going to be able to squeeze past? No. No, we can't. Could ram out of the way, but that's not very realistic at all. So we'll go around the front like a civilized human being. And we'll collect some water. Now, there shouldn't be anything in this, I don't think. I don't think there is, anyway. So we'll go ahead, reverse, and hook this up. Now, this is a manual water bowser for the people that haven't seen it before. So we'll jump out of here. What side do we have from? We have to be on this side, which is a little bit annoying, but oh well. So we'll hook it up. We'll get the leg manually lifted up here. There we go. Jump back in, and we'll go fill her up. Let's close that down. Now, here's a little shortcut I like to take. It's not necessarily unrealistic. It's just maybe a little bit damaging on the paint. But there we go. There's my little shortcut. I'm pretty sure I'm not the only person that uses it. Is it R? Nope. R? There we go. There's the water. It's that blue thing there. Now, whilst that fills up, people do moan that I use this for water because apparently it's fertilizer. But technically, it says H2O tank on it. So it's technically a water tank. It's just that a lot of map makers use it for water, for fertilizer. So technically, Auction David is the one the correct in this argument. So I completely agree with what he's done. It's just we're so used to it being the fertilizer tank that we thought it was. I was one of them as well, to be fair. Right, so we'll jump across the yard here. Give the girls a drink. And this is making me really thirsty talking about all this water. I think I'm going to have to get a glass of water myself in a minute. Well, that's what I was going to show you. This is the Lundberg. Lundberg. That's the one. The Lundberg mixer, which I believe was an FS15 as well. Alright, through here. Did we close the gate? I don't remember closing this gate. And they also started to kick up the food again, which is annoying. Behave. Where's your table manners at? Alright. Jump back in. I forgot to open the door we got out then, but ignore that. Move! Oi, Boris! Out the way! And you, Sandra, out the way. Now, what side of the water trough do we need to be on? That's the question. I'm going to go with this side for now. Wait, is this going to work? Yes, there we go. There's actually some water in there. They don't need that much. Maybe we should have just filled it up 50%. Wow. They literally took hardly anything. There we go. So everything's looking good, apart from grass. There's nothing we can do about grass yet, because as you can see, the grass still hasn't recovered fully from the winter. So hopefully it'll be back soon. Let's go through here. So for the last time today, we'll close this gate. Maybe I am closing it. I'm just losing my mind. It's more likely. I'm very tired. I might get that. I might actually get that mod where they're a little bit cleaner, because it gets very, very annoying. Clean up after them every 3 seconds. Right, onwards. What happens if you try and feed them water from here? Absolutely nothing. Nope, that's a game extension. Cool. So that is that for the animals today. So there's the, this is actually what I do daily, by the way. Before I record a video, I usually do this chore, which is why you never see any, like, animal warnings at the top and stuff, because before I record a video, I usually do this every day on Farm Sim, because I have to. Keep the cows nice and healthy, because they do die with Seasons Mod. That's another thing that's going to be a shock to people. If you don't feed them, the cows do die. No, you don't get to see a dead cow or anything, but they just disappear. So we'll get that lifted up like that. I'm not sure how that's lifted up the back wheels of the tractor, but there we go. Okay, I think we're done. So I'll quickly turn that off. Make sure everything's off. We'll lock the door for today. And we'll do our first task, which is to go and maintain the harvesters. So, yeah, this is another thing that the Seasons Mod... Oh, that's a chainsaw. Yeah, the Seasons Mod also adds vehicle maintenance, which most of you guys know, but if you're new to the channel, maybe you didn't. And we do have the toolbox mod. I say mod. It's actually a... you have to put it in with Giant's Editor, but it's a toolbox that we can use. So we'll... we'll collect that like so. And we'll head over to the combine. So yes, this is not just a decoration toolbox I use for roleplay. It does actually have a trigger attached to it. And we only want the Lexion today. We'll do the Jaguar another time. And let's drop that like that. One more thing we're going to get. A ladder. Cool. We'll get this ladder. And we'll see if we can get to the engine bay and all that. There we go. I think we can... Oh gosh, it didn't like that. The game did not like that at all. Climb up here. I think we can actually open some IC stuff. So we'll just open everything. Why not? Right, so there we go. It is now in maintenance mode. So we'll jump up the ladder. And as you can see, all the bonnet and stuff is open. We just need to get the toolbox up. But this is going to be the most challenging part. Because I got a feeling... Giant's physics, yo. Or farm some physics. I got a feeling it's going to chuck the harvester around. Nope, missed that completely. No, it freaked out. Oh god, this isn't going well. I thought this would be easy. Oh well. I'll just show you what I meant though, and what I was getting at. So with the IC stuff on this combine, we jump up. You can see all the engine stuff's actually open. It's a Mercedes engine. Who'd have known? I didn't actually know that. That's interesting. So we should be able to... OR? Where's the toolbox? Here it is. OR. Nothing is in the trigger. Let's move it around a little bit. I think it's pointing downwards at the moment, which isn't great. There we go. Vehicle maintenance. Unit perform maintenance on the Class Lexion 700 Big for 4,000. Wow. We'll actually see how bad it is, first of all, so I can show you guys some more features. So we'll try and start up the Lexion and see how far we get. So I'll be quiet so you can hear the engine. Absolutely nothing. Completely dead. You can see in the bottom right corner there. Trying to start it. Oh. We have it. She started eventually, but as you can tell, she was very hesitant to start. So she's in desperate need of some loving, which is why we're doing this now. So, oh, our maintenance, 4,000. Quite expensive, but now it should start first time. So we'll give it a go. Awesome. So we'll leave her powering up a little bit. Move this ladder out of the way here. Just chuck it down there for now. Right, so... how do we get up on top here? I don't think we can without the ladder. Don't think there's a way to get on top. Oh, we found a way up. So this fan should be spinning. Don't want to get too close because it takes our legs off. Engine's powering away. Cool. Close everything up. That should be it. Cool. And we'll take it for a little test drive. So that's going to be it for me. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, please tap my thumbs up button. It really does mean a lot. Hit subscribe to see more from myself. I've been Simulate Gaming, and I'll see you in the next one. Let's go for a little test drive.